we think about grid storage batteries, we think about batteries that are significantly larger, but in the lab, we obviously can't build batteries of that size, so these represent reasonable scale models.
My name is Fikile Brushett. Fikile is a South African name. I usually go by Fik. I'm an associate professor of chemical engineering here at MIT, and my group works on energy. In particular, we work on advancing the science and engineering of electrochemical technologies and the role they may play in the future energy economy.
This is where the electrochemical reactions actually occur. So this is when you do.
The reason you're able to take your cell phone and walk around all day is because you have a battery that provides power for that device, and at the end of the day, you just recharge it. The way the battery works is it takes the electrical energy that it harvests from your outlet in the wall and stores it in chemical energy. If we start to go to other energy storage needs, such as batteries to power cars, the cost of that battery has to come down and the performance needs to go up. If you take it then to the grid and say, I need batteries in order to smooth out the delivery of renewable energy, that battery needs to last significantly longer than the battery in my cell phone, and it needs to be significantly cheaper. A lot of times electrochemical technologies work in some areas, but we'd like them to work much more broadly than we've asked them to do beforehand, and they're stringent cost, performance, and durability targets that we need to hit. And a lot of that is now driving the need for new innovation in the area. And that's where we come in.